Seatbelts, everyone! Please let this be a normal field trip.
With a friend? No way!
Cruising on down Main Street, you're relaxed and feeling good. Next thing that you know, you'll see it. Octopus in my neighborhood. Surfing on a sine wave. Swinging through the stars. Yeah. Take a left at human testing. Take your second right past Mars. I'm a magic scuba. Alligator.
Anybody want to help me write a letter to my neighbors and apologize for the excessive noise? That would be greatly appreciated. Welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the F-150, and welcome back to the...
parking garage?
My garage is occupied with a bunch of crap and the Subaru, so I figured I'd come here because I know for a fact this place would be dead, and as predicted, not a soul in sight. So, the package to complete my exhaust setup on the F-150 has finally arrived. To catch you up to speed, I put a Flowmaster 40 series muffler on my 3.3 liter V6 F-150. So, I went ahead and I painted the tailpipe in a high heat flat black paint. And if you watch that video, you'll see that I already had an exhaust tip ready to be mounted on the F-150. But, we ran into an issue. A fitment issue to be specific. Here is the exhaust tip in question that I was going to originally install. It's a MBRP exhaust tip in a satin black, nice finish. Now, this is a 3.5 outlet. The inlet is a 3-inch, which I thought was universal amongst the F-150s. I thought we all had the 3-inch diameter tailpipe, but I was wrong. I didn't measure it. I should have. After I had that fitment issue, I measured the tailpipe on the F-150, and it turns out the diameter is 2.75 inches, or 2 inches 3 quarters. I thought this would work because it is somewhat adjustable to secure the fit, I guess, but it didn't fit. There was still a lot of play going on, and I was really mad because this thing cost me $70, but it's a nice-looking exhaust tip. I won't lie. It's a very nice-looking exhaust. Look at the rolled edge. Are you looking at that rolled edge, guys? That is beautiful. And the finish. And the logo. Look at the logo. Beautifully stamped across the exhaust tip. And unfortunately, I passed the return date, so I can't return it either. And that just infuriated me more. But then I realized that Amazon and eBay are a thing. And, well, cut to a few seconds later, I got my next exhaust tip chilling out there in the backseat. So, here it is, guys. The exhaust tip that I went with. We got the 2.75 inch inlet, 3.5 inch outlet, nice and angled, and it's in a very beautiful black satin finish. It's an exhaust tip, what else could I say? Let's compare it to the MBRP exhaust tip that I bought for $70. This is a lot nicer in quality. Obviously, look, the rolled edge, as I mentioned before, look at it. Rolled edge, angled, not nearly as aggressive as this one though, and the finish on this is significantly better than this one. Obviously, the quality is there on the $70 one. Just wish this thing fit because I like this one better. Painted in a nice flat black finish. And here we have, this is actually the first test that I'm gonna do. I've never tested this, I should have, but oh yeah. Oh yeah. There we go. Beautiful. All right, let's go ahead and secure it down. That's part of the reason why I like to keep my factory antenna, because it's a good indication of what the clearance I'm dealing with here, guys. This is what happens when I'm nice to the birds in my backyard. Yeah, alright. Okay, that's fine and all. On the window a little bit. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. These birds just had an all-you-could-eat buffet right here. I appreciate that, birds.
Thank you very much.
Anywho, guys, this is the exhaust tip. It looks beautiful, and I didn't even break the bank. Now, would it have been cool to have a nice rolled edge like the MBRP? Sure. But this is fine. I like this.
Love this. Gotta tighten it maybe a little bit more. But there we have it, guys. I will leave the link down below if you want to check it out.
This is something that's going to get addressed ASAP because this is just horrible. This is horrendous. I can't even drive the Subaru without the cat-back slapping against all this mud. Watch. Watch this, guys.
Look at that. Look at the, you probably can't even see it. Look at all that mud on the bottom of the cat-back on the Y-pipe.
Yeah, this is just too bad, guys. Terrible.
Needs to get addressed ASAP Rocky.
As soon as warmer temperatures are reached, we are making that a priority project, guys. Because we can't be having that mud in front of the garage all the time when it rains. It's fun in the trucks, and it's fun in the Subaru at times, but just that every single time I want to get a vehicle in and out, it's going to get dirty. Now, I do appreciate a dirtied up Subaru. It's just that now I don't want it all the time dirty. Guys, the sun is coming out as we speak, which means the Subaru is coming out. But as I said before,
the Subaru is pretty dang filthy. I can't tell you the last time that I cleaned this car up, inside or out, but it needs to be addressed. But not only does the Subaru need to be cleaned, guys, the garage is a complete mess. We got construction stuff, we got automotive stuff, we got a saltwater fish tank that we got as a gift. Now, I don't even know if I'm going to go through with this. I might just throw it away, sell it, give it to somebody, I don't know, because it's really complicated. A lot of equipment. If any of you have any experience with saltwater aquariums, please holler at me because I'm a complete noob. And I think I'm a little over my head on this project, guys. But garage is a mess. Construction, automotive, everything is here, guys. It's just horrendous.
And you know what they say, an organized environment is an organized mind.
We got vinyl wraps, all sorts of vinyl wraps. We even got the, look at that, we even got full ones over there.
Spring cleaning, guys. We gotta do the Subaru, we gotta do the garage. The other important thing is I need to fix my license plate. It's dangling. I have a relocator on it. However, I didn't properly secure it, so it's, yeah, my tags are dangling. They're dangling. So the garage is, it's all right. It's a lot better than before.
Let's go ahead and tackle the license plate relocator kit. So here it is, grip speed relocator kit. It is obviously not holding in its position right there where it's supposed to be. God's gonna get you, kid. But pride's gonna be the death of you. I think with a good vacuum and a good wipe, we should be solid. Bit of a difference here. Sort of. Looks better. Like the brushes. Helps a ton to scrub out all that dirt and those particles that are caught in between the fibers. I need vacuum. Shift boot definitely needs a vacuum. Handbrake boot and the armrest thing. I'm gonna do a completely separate video on detailing the STI, which is soon to come, because one, we got warmer temperatures coming, and two, I'm gonna level with you guys and say in the six or seven years of owning this STI, I've never actually detailed it. Yeah, I know, I'm a horrible owner, I'm aware. But actually, it's pretty good timing because one, if you've been keeping up, I recently unwrapped the STI. It was fully vinyl wrapped and I took it off completely. I've had that vinyl wrap for probably, I think, 2 or 3 years now. It's probably 2 years. And we're back to paint. However, I took off the wrap on a fairly chilly day, which means that there's still adhesion and vinyl left over on the car itself. You'll see it right now. I mean, look at that. See that? That is due to the vinyl wrap. Now you'll see a lot of it. Let's see if I can find some more. Look, we got another one right there. Now this isn't damage or anything to the paint. It's literally just the vinyl
adhesive stuff that was left on the car. Now, there's quite a few, actually. Actually, more than a few. There's a lot. That's why it's actually good timing that we're going to detail this car, because now we can do all paint correction and everything. We can finally give it that TLC and attention that it deserves.
So, that is going to do it for STI news. Basically, giving it a full detail. For F-150 news, I'm looking at picking up a Raptor-style front bumper for the F-150. Now, I have the XL version, which means basic, no fog lights, no paint match bumpers, none of that stuff. So, I figured, why not make the front end look a little bit nicer. I was also looking at some new headlights for the truck. The only thing is, I'm a little hesitant. Because of the front grille that I have, guys, it has those, you know, the amber and LED front lights on the grille itself. I feel like it might be too much. I might be going overboard on the front end. It's going to be a lot going on. It's going to be busy. So, I don't know. I'm kind of hesitant on the headlights. That's why I kind of want to do the front bumper first. The only drawback with the front bumper, guys, is that I have a bull bar on the front. I love it. I'm just not sure if I'm going to be able to put it on once I have the Raptor-style front bumper on the truck. I don't know. I could be paying 200 and something bucks to lose my bull bar or to have a super aggressive, tough front end appearance on the truck. Be on the lookout for that, guys. Even more of a reason to subscribe and keep up with the builds. Two, as I mentioned before, I pretty much mentioned all the F-150 videos, but I am vinyl wrapping it. I do have the hood of the truck already vinyl wrapped. I have more and more rolls. In fact, I think two of those rolls are probably the satin black that I'm doing on the truck. As I mentioned, warmer temperatures are approaching, guys, which means we can vinyl wrap the F-150 properly now. I've been so impatient. I've tried doing the roof, and I've tried doing other bits and pieces, and that was a waste of money because I literally tore the vinyl. I don't have central heating in the garage. So I was being impatient, and we lost a good amount of vinyl that pissed me off. But I learned my lesson. And we're going to wait until warmer temperatures arrive so we can fully wrap the F-150, guys. And I'm super excited to do that because, I mean, it's going to be fully blacked out, murdered out F-150. As always, guys, be sure to comment, like, and subscribe. I will catch you all on the next one. Peace and take care.